Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. I'm happy to share with you these facts on Carcharodontosaurus. Carcharodontosaurus was a large Carcharodontosaurid theropod dinosaur that existed during the Cenomanian stage of the mid-Cretaceous period in northern Africa. It is currently known to include two species, Carcharodontosaurus saharicus and iguidensis, which are among the largest theropods, nearly as large or even larger than Tyrannosaurus, Giganotosaurus, and Spinosaurus. With serrated, knife-like teeth, Carcharodontosaurus could slice through the flesh of prey. These teeth were essential to the hunting strategy of Carcharodontosaurus, because when these teeth are arranged in a mouth the size that Carcharodontosaurus had, they would create a massive open wound. It is this wound that would effectively incapacitate the prey, as blood loss would be so great that shock would quickly set in. This would cause the prey to become lethargic and disoriented, allowing Carcharodontosaurus to easily close in and finish it off. Carcharodontosaurus is often falsely dubbed the African T-Rex, something which has misled many people into believing that they are the same. In reality, the only similarities that they share are that they are both theropod dinosaurs, and with this analogy, you may as well call Carcharodontosaurus the African Velociraptor. It would be no more true or false than calling it the African T-Rex. The difference between Carcharodontosaurus and Tyrannosaurus is immediately clear by looking at just the teeth. Carcharodontosaurus has laterally compressed or flattened teeth that slice through flesh. In contrast, Tyrannosaurus has round conical teeth for crushing bone. Include other differences like size and shape of the skull and overall body proportions, and it's clear that the two are completely unrelated. In 1924, two teeth were discovered in the intercontinental intercalaire of Algeria, showing what were at the time unique traits. These teeth were described by De Parrott and Sabernan in 1925 as representing a new taxon, which they named Megalosaurus saharicus, and later categorized in the subgenus Dryptosaurus. Some years later, paleontologist Ernst Stromer described the remains of a partial skull and skeleton from Cenomanian age rocks in the Baharija formation of Egypt, named by Stromer in 1931. Originally excavated in 1914, the remains consisted of a partial skull, teeth, vertebrae, claw bones, and assorted hip and leg bones. The teeth in this new finding matched the characteristics of those described by De Parrott and Sabernan, which led to Stromer conserving the species name saharicus, yet finding it necessary to erect a new genus for this species, Carcharodontosaurus, for their strong resemblance to the teeth of Carcharodon, or the great white shark. Although Carcharodontosaurus was named as its own genus by Ernst Stromer in 1931, it was actually known to science 4 years earlier. Nonetheless, when it was first described in 1927, it was described as a species of Megalosaurus. Although Megalosaurus is still one of the best known dinosaur names today, back in the early days of paleontology, it and many others were used as wastebasket taxons, where material was assigned upon the grounds of superficial similarity. Even back then, it was clear that Carcharodontosaurus was most probably slightly bigger than Tyrannosaurus, the dinosaur that was hailed as the biggest meat eater for the best part of a century. The main reason for the relative obscurity of Carcharodontosaurus throughout most of the 20th century is that its only remains were destroyed in an Allied bombing raid on Munich in 1944 during World War II, an event that destroyed other fossils like the first Spinosaurus remains and the skull of the giant crocodiliform, Stomatosuchus. Nonetheless, a new, more complete skull was found in the Kemkem formation of Morocco during an expedition led by paleontologist Paul Sereno in 1995, near the Algerian border, and the locality where the teeth described by De Parrott and Sabernan in 1925 were found. The teeth found with this new skull matched those described by De Parrott and Sabernan in 1925 and Stromer in 1931. The rest of the skull also matched that described by Stromer. The new skull was designated as the neotype by Broussard and Sereno in 2007, who also described a second species of Carcharodontosaurus, Carcharodontosaurus iguidensis, from the Etchkar formation of Niger, differing from Carcharodontosaurus saharicus in aspects of the maxilla and brain case. The taxonomy of Carcharodontosaurus was discussed in Chorienza and Cao in 2016, who noted the neotype of Carcharodontosaurus saharicus was similar yet distinct from the holotype, which is problematic because the holotype of Carcharodontosaurus saharicus is more closely related to the holotype of Carcharodontosaurus iguidensis than the neotype, SGMDIN1. The authors also identified the referred material of Carcharodontosaurus iguidensis as belonging to Sigillomastosaurus and a non-Carcharodontosaurian, and therefore chose to limit Carcharodontosaurus iguidensis to the holotype pending future research. Interest began a rise in Carcharodontosaurus in the mid-1990s with the discovery of new Carcharodontosaurus material, resulting in the naming of the second species, Carcharodontosaurus iguidensis, in 2007. Additionally, another dinosaur named Sigillomastosaurus brevicaulis was suggested as a junior synonym by Paul Sereno et al. In 1998 based upon strong similarities between it and Carcharodontosaurus. Nonetheless, a study in 2005 by Nobus et al. Has cast doubts upon this claim, pointing out several differences between the associated Sigillomastosaurus material and that of Carcharodontosaurus. Even if Sigillomastosaurus is confirmed to be its own genus, the new fossil material of Carcharodontosaurus is enough to once again reconstruct this ancient predator, as well as confirm its slightly larger size than Tyrannosaurus. The resurgence of interest in Carcharodontosaurus can still be seen today, with its almost mandatory inclusion in dinosaur books, appearances in video games, and increasing appearances in dinosaur documentaries like the BBC series Planet Dinosaur. Carcharodontosaurus includes some of the longest and heaviest known carnivorous dinosaurs, with numerous scientists proposing length estimates for the species Carcharodontosaurus saharicus, ranging between 39 and 44 feet, or 12 and 13.3 meters, and weight estimates between 6.2 to 15.1 metric tons, or 6.8 to 16.6 short tons. In 2016, Molina Perez and Laramendi gave a length of 42 feet, or 12.8 meters, and a weight of 7.8 metric tons, or 8.6 short tons, for the neotype of Carcharodontosaurus saharicus, and a length of 36 feet, or 11 meters, and a weight of 5.2 metric tons, or 5.7 short tons, for a referred tooth of Carcharodontosaurus iguidensis. Carcharodontosaurus were carnivores, with enormous jaws and long, serrated teeth, up to 8 inches, or 20 centimeters long. A skull length of about 4.7 feet, or 1.42 meters, has been restored for the neotype of Carcharodontosaurus saharicus. Currently, the largest known theropod skull belongs to another massive Carcharodontosaurid dinosaur, the closely related Giganotosaurus, with skull estimates of up to 6.4 feet, or 1.95 meters, yet this has been disputed. Gregory S. Paul estimates Carcharodontosaurus iguidensis at 33 feet, or 10 meters and 4 metric tons, or 4.4 short tons. The discovery of new fossil material allowed for detailed studies into the brain of Carcharodontosaurus and how it may have lived and hunted. Carcharodontosaurus is often referenced as having a much smaller brain than Tyrannosaurus, even though it's slightly larger, leading to the ungracious statement that it was much dumber. Nevertheless, such a statement is a grave misnomer, as brain size itself is not as important as the development of individual parts of the brain, like senses, memory, and reasoning. For instance, an animal with greatly enlarged sensory areas like smell and vision would have a larger brain than another animal that was not as well adapted, yet was still no more intelligent because the brain tissue for those areas do not make an animal better at thinking about problem solving, just able to detect things. In 2001, Hans C. E. Larsen published a description of the inner ear and endocranium of Carcharodontosaurus saharicus. Starting from the portion of the brain closest to the tip of the animal's snout is the forebrain, which is followed by the midbrain. The midbrain is angled downwards at a 45 degree angle and towards the rear of the animal. This is followed by the hindbrain, which is roughly parallel to the forebrain and forms a roughly 40 degree angle with the brain. Overall, the brain of Carcharodontosaurus saharicus would have been similar to that of a related dinosaur, Allosaurus fragilis. Larsen found that the ratio of the cerebrum to the volume of the brain overall in Carcharodontosaurus was typical for a non-avian reptile. Carcharodontosaurus also had a large optic nerve. The brain of Carcharodontosaurus exhibits features that hail back to the early archosaurs, with similarities being seen in other reptiles like turtles and crocodiles. However, the interesting thing is that the brain layout of Carcharodontosaurus is different to those of birds, and this reveals a growing evolutionary trend in dinosaurs that Carcharodontosaurus was not part of. The smaller brain size of Carcharodontosaurus was probably predetermined by its Archosaurian ancestry, as many theropods of his ancestral line also have similar brain sizes, meaning that while their bodies grew bigger, the brains remained the same, bringing a halt to further biological development. However, the coelurosaurian dinosaurs, which is a lineage that would include Tyrannosaurus and the transitional line of birds, developed their brains away from the older archosaurian form, allowing for the potential of greater reasoning. This could be part of the reason why predators along the Carcharodontosaurid lineage would eventually disappear before the end of the Cretaceous, when the new forms were more dominant. Predators rely greatly upon their sense of smell for tracking prey over distances, although it's also probable that Carcharodontosaurus fed from carcasses of already dead dinosaurs when it was fortunate enough to find such an easy meal. When it came to killing its own prey, Carcharodontosaurus seems to have been a primarily visually oriented predator, evidenced by a large optic nerve, relying upon stereoscopic vision to provide depth perception to allow it to gauge distances between itself and prey. The three semicircular canals of the inner ear of Carcharodontosaurus saharicus, when viewed from the side, had a subtriangular outline. The subtriangular inner ear configuration is present in Allosaurus, turtles, lizards, yet not in birds. The semicircular canals themselves were actually very linear, which explains the pointed silhouette. In life, the flocular lobe of the brain would have projected into the area surrounded by the semicircular canals, just like in other non-avian theropods, birds, and pterosaurs. A study by Donald Henderson, the curator of dinosaurs at the Royal Tyrrell Museum, suggests that Carcharodontosaurus was able to lift animals weighing a maximum of 935 pounds or 424 kilograms in its jaws, based on the strength of its jaws, neck, and its center of mass. SGM-DIN1, a Carcharodontosaurus saharicus skull, has a circular puncture wound in the nasal and an abnormal projection of bone on the anorbital rim. Carcharodontosaurus means shark-toothed lizard. The name Carcharodontosaurus is derived from the Carcharodon genus of sharks, a group famous for including the great white shark. This name was chosen because the teeth are sharp and serrated in a similar manner to the great white sharks, something that meant they could slice through the flesh of prey like sharp knives. It is made up of the Greek karkaros, meaning jagged or sharp, and odon, meaning teeth, and the suffix saurus, meaning lizard. It was named by Ernst Stromer in 1931. It belongs to the kingdom Animalia, the phylum Chordata, the clade Dinosauria, Saurischia, and Theropoda, the infraorder Carnosauria, the family Carcharodontosauridae, the subfamily Carcharodontosaurinae, the genus Carcharodontosaurus, and the type species Carcharodontosaurus saharicus. The following cladogram after Epistugia et al. In 2016 shows the placement of Carcharodontosaurus within Carcharodontosauridae. Carcharodontosaurus has been used to define its own group, the Carcharodontosauridae, which includes other large theropods like Giganotosaurus, Mapusaurus, and Tyrannotitan. All of these predators have proportionately large skulls, large fenestra, or skull openings, and serrated slicing teeth designed for cutting flesh rather than crunching bone. Carcharodontosaurids seem to have evolved from earlier theropods like Allosaurus, and again this would display a different lineage from the Tyrannosaurids, which evolved from a coelurosaurian lineage. The Carcharodontosaurids were quite common at one time during the Cretaceous, being represented by Acrocanthosaurus in North America, Neovenator in Western Europe, and Shaochilong in China. Nonetheless, the Carcharodontosaurids disappeared from the fossil record prior to the end of the Cretaceous, being replaced by Tyrannosaurids in the north and Abelosaurids in the south. Synonyms include Megalosaurus africanus and Megalosaurus saharicus. Species include the type species Carcharodontosaurus saharicus and a second species Carcharodontosaurus iguidensis. Carcharodontosaurus was a carnivore. It was between 39.4 to 42.7 feet, or between 12 and 13 meters long. Carcharodontosaurus has been discovered in a wide range of locations, including the continental intercalar formation of Algeria, possibly the Alcantara Formation of Brazil, the Bahrajan Mut Formation of Egypt, the Oufos and Kemkem Formation of Morocco, the Continental Intercalar, Etchkar, and El Ras Formation of Niger, and the Continental Intercalar and Chinini Formation of Tunisia. Carcharodontosaurus lived during the Cenomanian of the mid-Cretaceous, roughly 100.5 to 93.9 million years ago. Fossil representation includes initial remains destroyed in World War II, with further material, including enough to name a second species, since being found. Carcharodontosaurus has seen a prolific rise in popular culture throughout the years, appearing in the game Jurassic Park, Operation Genesis, Jurassic Park Builder, Ark Survival Evolve as a Jurassic Park mod, and in Jurassic World Evolution as part of the Cretaceous Dinosaur Pack DLC. It has been featured in Monsters Resurrected, Losing the Spinosaurus, Lost World from Planet Dinosaur, in the Christmas TV special Toy Story The Time Forgot, as a character named Reptilius Maximus, Champion of the Battlesaurus, and in Dinosaur Train. A North African Cretaceous dinosaur, among the largest theropods to ever exist, and almost as large or possibly even larger than Tyrannosaurus and Giganotosaurus, Carcharodontosaurus, large, packed with knife-like teeth, and an archosaur-like brain. Thank you for joining me in this shorter episode of Dinosaurs on Earth. The channel is rather near to the 1,000 subscribers mark, so I have to thank you guys for your support. It has propelled me forward amid challenges along the way. I want to feature a few recent feats that are great. First, the Cryptid Case Skunk Ape episode surpassed 1,000 views. The Dinosaurs on Earth Suchomimus episode surpassed 9,000 views. The Fax Nurse Shark episode surpassed 3,000 views. The Fax Torbosaurus surpassed 1,000 views, and the Fax Pikea surpassed 1,000 views. So lots of good news. I have some really exciting projects for this summer. So stay tuned for more, and as always, thank you for watching. This is Enchiridion. See you next time.